Electronic Sins heartily welcome you to know real-time circuit 1. Winners always have positive mind in all occasions. Thank you for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe to this YouTube channel. Receive more electronics information. Kindly suggest your valuable feedback to improve the forthcoming videos. Thank you, Electronic Sins. The given circuits are real-time circuits. These circuits are different from lab circuits. Constructing, testing and understanding the working of these circuits gives real knowledge. The cost of the circuit is very low. Better to construct the circuits on the breadboard because you can reuse the components. Multi-terminal power supply. The multi-terminal power supply has two parts. Part 1. The figure 1 shows the circuit diagram of rectifier with filter and regulator. It has two outputs. One is 24 volts unregulated power supply and another is 15 volts regulated power supply. Multiple power supply with regulator, figure 1. It has the transformer, the bridge rectifier, the pi RC filter and the regulator. The transformer step down the incoming 230 AC volts to 15 volts AC. The bridge rectifier, 4 diodes, converts the AC voltage to pulsating DC voltage. The pulsating DC voltage has ripples. The pi RC, 2 numbers of 1000 mu F, 25 volts and the 100 ohm resistor, filter removes the ripple. The regulator IC7815 regulates the filtered DC volts to 15 volts DC. The unregulated 25 volts is also available. Part 2. This figure shows multi-regulated voltages. The important component of the circuit is ICLM317. It is an adjustable voltage regulator. It has 6 selecting switch resistors and filter capacitors. The selecting switch selects the output voltage. The resistors are used to design the output voltage. The value of the resistor is obtained from the formula Vout equal to 1.25 1 plus R2 by R1 into 100 into 10 power minus 3 R2. The capacitors remove the noise. The output voltage can be varied from 3.3 volts to 15 volts. Slight variation in the output volts due to the tolerance of the resistors. Transformer less power supply. The transformer is bulky and occupies more space. The transformer less power supply is compact and it requires small space. The mobile charge is a transformer less rectifier with regulator circuit. The figure shows the circuit diagram of transformer less power supply. The circuit diagram is given. The circuit shows a simple mobile charger. It is a transformer less bridge rectifier with capacitor input filter and Zener regulator. The main component is the voltage dropping resistor and the X-rated capacitor. They are used to reduce the incoming AC voltage. The capacitor is a non-polarized, so it can be connected to any side. The value is 0.47 mu F, 400 volt. The resistor connected in parallel is used for discharging the capacitor when the supply is off. Better use R4, 100 ohm, 5 watt instead of 100 ohm, 1 watt. The reduced AC voltage is rectified by the bridge rectifier. The output of the rectifier is filtered by the capacitor input filter. Then it is regulated by the Zener circuit. The main disadvantage of the circuit is it does not work properly when the load current is more 100 milliampere. Double polarity power supply. The double polarity power supply is used in op-amp circuits. It has a center tap transformer, the bridge rectifier, noise filter, filter capacitor, regulator IC7815. the transformer step down the incoming 220 volts to 18 volts. The bridge rectifier rectify the AC voltage. It produces the pulsating DC voltage and the pulsating DC voltage as ripples. The ripples are removed by the filter capacitors C1, C2, C5 and C6. The noise capacitors C3 and C4 attenuates the noise signal. The IC7812 gives the positive regulated DC voltage with respect to 0 volt terminal. The IC7912 gives the negative regulated DC voltage with respect to 0 volt terminal. Servicing the rectifier circuit. Servicing. Step 1. Set the multimeter at 10 volt DC. Step 2. Keep the negative terminal of the meter at 0 volt. Step 3. Touch the positive terminal at the point 7. Step 4. If the meter shows the 0 volt. Step 5. Check the point 5. If the meter shows the reading, the fault is IC. Remove the IC from the circuit and replace the new IC. Step 6. If the meter shows the 0 volt at the point 5. Step 7. Set the meter at AC range 10 volt range. Step 8. Keep the black terminal of the meter at the bottom wire of the secondary side of the transformer. Step 9. Check the point 3. If the meter shows the reading, replace 47 mu F capacitor. Step 10. Again, if the does not show the reading, check the point 2. If the shows the reading, check the fuse. Step 11. If the fuse is not right, change the fuse. Step 12. If the fuse is right, change the range of meter to 500 volt AC. Step 13. Check the primary side of the transformer. If the meter shows the reading, change the transformer. Step 14. If the meter does not show the incoming supply. Step 15. If the incoming supply is right, change the transformer. Thanks to Google and Books. Kindly view my next video. Kindly recreate the mistakes in the video. Thank you for your visit to this channel.